Hello everyone, this is Mayank Gupta and welcome to my 8th lecture of my Python series while loop in Python. So today's subtopics are while loop, count up and down, if else statement with while loop, break statement, continue statement in while loop, and at last test two skills in which a question is given in your screen and you have to answer in our comment box. So let's start. While loop. A while loop statement in Python programming language repeatedly executes a target statement as long as a given condition is true. So it will iterate till our condition is true. And whenever our condition is false, it will exit from our while loop. So let's code it. So let's take an example. Suppose I am writing x equal to 10. Okay, not 10, 5. Okay, so I'm writing a while loop. So keep it 1. Now, so x while x less than 5, print hello Mayank. Okay, and increment or decrement, so x equal to x plus 1. So what is happening here? Here I have initialized x with a value 1 and it will check first this condition. So our x is equal to 1, so 1 is less than 5, the condition is true, it will print hello Mayank. Okay, then it will I'm doing increment here. So x equals to x plus 1. So what is the value of x? 1. So 1 plus 1, 2. So here value in x is 2. Now again it will check here. Now 2 is less than 5. Then it will again print hello Mayank. Again increment, 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. And means x equals to 3. Now again it will check here condition. So 3 is less than 5, it will again print hello Mayank and again increment, then x equals to 4. Now again it will check. So 4 is less than 5, it will again print hello Mayank. This is the fourth time. Now our x is 4 plus 1 equals to 5. So x equals to 5. Now 5 is less than 5. So this condition is false. So it will exit from our while loop. So let's write end here. So you can see here I had written print in with an indentation. You can see indentation using tab button, and also here also x equals to x plus 1. This means this part is in while loop, but this print statement I have not given any indentation, so this means this is not a part of while loop. So let's run this code. You can see here the output, 4 times hello Mayank and at last end. Why? Because here x is iterated 4 times, so it prints hello Mayank 4 times, and after the execution when our condition is false, it will exit our while loop and it will print end. Okay, so let's move to our next topic. This is the flow diagram of while loop. Here the code ints, and here the condition is checked. If the condition is true, it will go to the condition code, it will again check the condition, then again if true, then it will executes the condition code. And till the condition is true, whenever we get false, it will exit the loop. Count up and down. So let's suppose I tell you to print from 1 to 5. Okay, then it is not necessary to write 5 time print statement. Then you can also use x here. Okay, so x is less than equal to 5. Now print x. Now what is happening here? X equals to 1. Okay, Now it will check the condition x, when say x less than equal to 5 means 1 is less than equal to 5, then the condition is true. It will print x. Then what is the value of x? 1. Then it will increase it. So increment is occurring here. So now x equals to 2. Now 2 is less than equal to 5. Again it will print 2. Now x value of x is 2. So it will print 2. Again increment. So x equals to 3. Now again it will check condition. Now x is equal to 3. 3 is less than equal to 5. Now print x. What is the value of x? 3. So it will print 3. And so on till 5. After 5, when our final x is 6, so 6 is not less than equal to 5, so this condition is false. So it will terminate, our x will be terminated. So it will print the end. Now let's run this code. You can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and at last end. So let's go. Okay, now let's count it down. So let's change into 5. Now x greater than equal to 0. Okay, x equals to x minus 1. Now what is happening here? Same thing. Now here x equals to 5, right? Then 5 is greater than equal to 0. Sorry, not equal to, greater than 0. If we want to print till 1, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, we are counting down till 1. Okay, so 5 is less than 0, yes, 2, then it will print 5. Now here decrement is occurring, so 5 minus 1 is equal to 4. So here I am assigning 4 to x. Now 4 is greater than 0, so yes, true, so it will print 4, x means 4. Now again decrement, so 4 minus 1 equals to 3. Now we are assigning x equals to 3. So again 3 is greater than 0, condition is true, so it will run till x equals to 1 minus 1 means 0. So x, when the final x will be 0, now condition will be checked, 0 is greater than 0, now false, then it will be exited from the loop. So it will print end. Run it. You can see here the output 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 and end. Now if else statement in with while loop. Okay, now just let me change a few lines of this code. X is less than 5. Now x equals to x plus 1. Okay, now here I am writing if x is less than 3. Okay, print less than 3. Okay, now else print greater than or equal to 3, but I am only writing greater than 3. Okay, so greater than 3. Now let's run this code. You can see here for 1, when the value of x is 1, okay, let's start from beginning. When the value of x is 1, condition is checked if x is less than 5. So 1 is less than 5, so the condition is true. Now if condition is checked, so 1 less than 3, then so this code block will be output, so less than 3. Okay, then increment. Now x equals to true. Now again 2 is less than 5, condition is true. Again here if condition is also true, 2 is less than 3, so again less than 3 will be output. Now x equals to 2 plus 1 means final x is 3. So now this condition is true, x is less than 5 means 3 is less than 5. Now this condition is false, 3 is not less than 3, so it will go to else block. So print greater than 3. So our output is greater than 3. Again x equals to 3 plus 1 means x is equal to 4. So again this condition is true, 4 is less than 5, If x is less than 3 means 4 is less than 3, so false. So it will go to else. So our else block, code of else block will be output, so greater than 3. Okay. Now break statement. Break statement is used to terminate a running loop. So let's see. I'm writing a break statement. See. Break statement is used to terminate a loop. So suppose I want to terminate a loop when x equals to 3. Okay. So just write a print also. Here write a break. And write print here. Print x. So what is happening here? X equals to 1. Okay, so this condition is true. 1 is less than 5. It will print x. Okay, means 1. Output will be 1. Then it will check this if condition. X equals to 3. Then this condition is false. Okay, and there is no else. So x equals to x plus 1 means 1 plus 1, 2. So our final x is 2. Now it will again check. 2 is less than 5. True. It will print x means it will output 2. Again it will check if x equals to 3. So no, this is false. So again increment 2 plus 1, 3. Now 3 is less than 5, true. Okay, this will output 3, print 3. Now this condition is true, x equals to 3, yes. Then this will break our loop. Now loop will not be continued. Okay, so let's check the output. It will output 1 2 3 and end. You can see here the output 1 2 3 and end. Why? Because when x equals to 3 found, it break the loop. This break statement will terminate the loop. Continue statement in while loop. Continue statement is used to stop the current iteration and to continue in next execution. So for this I am writing this x equals to x plus 1 in upper line. So continue statement just break it once, means it just stop the current iteration. Like let me show you continue. So what will happen here? Okay, write this print x, remove this print x from here. Okay, now what is happening here? X equals to 1, so this condition is true. Increment is occurring here, so equals to 2, right? Why? X equal to 1, 1 is less than 5. X equals to 1 plus 1 means 2. Our final x is true, 2. Then here the condition is checked, it is false, then it will print 2. Now again condition is checked, 2 is less than 5, again increment, x equals to 2 plus 1, means our final x is 3. Now condition is checked, so this condition is true, then it will continue, then means it will not go below this line, means print x will not be executed, it will again execute from while loop again. Now x equals to 3 plus 1, 4. Now it will check this condition, so false. So it is just pausing the current iteration. Okay, it is just removing the current iteration. Now let's run this code. You can see here the output 2 4 5, because when x equal to 3, it doesn't, our code doesn't reach the print x. Okay, so here is the question. Test your skills, solve it by on and answer in our comment box. So if you liked our video, please like, comment and share my video and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.